I would find that between cities, I'd be at the airports ready to fly on to the next part of my book tour, and I'd look into bookstores, and, you know, there'd be the typical Angela's Ashes, Cold Mountain, you know, in the windows. So what I used to do is I used to get all my books, and when people weren't watching, I'd change all the displays in the windows in the airports, and I'd go, now that's a better display to me. It'd just be Tracey Takes On everywhere. I've realised, doing the whole book thing, being on book tours and selling books, if I'd have put Princess Diana and a swastika and a picture of the Titanic on the front of this, I would have sold millions of the buggers.
This book the Royals by Kitty Kelly's been banned in England, so I brought a copy in San Fran Airport and I'm smuggling it back to England for my Auntie Iris. Oh, these people are a bloody disgrace, you know. If a quarter of what's in here is true, we should guillotine the lot of them outside Buckingham Palace.
What are you reading, Trevor?
Oh, I just confiscated this off that French bloke in Club Brenda.
Well, we know what to do with this, don't we?
Oh, yeah.
Disgusting.
Very patriotic, our Brenda. Ever since she found a hat in an overhead locker that belonged to the Duchess of Kent, she took it home and she wears it at the weekends. She thinks she's one of them. Well, there's only one queen on this flight, and he is not amused. Oh, bloody hell.
This is us.
Yes.
Thank you.
Come on in. This is
You know, I think that these books on tape are just wonderful. I mean, it's such a great opportunity for the blind to enjoy one of life's simple pleasures.
Oh, but they're not only for the blind, Miss Granger.
Oh, I didn't mean to leave out the deaf. Now, what have you picked out for me today?
The portable checkoff. Your manager told me that you're very familiar with his work.
Maybe a little too familiar. You know, I was staying in the same hotel as a Star Trek convention, and Bill Shatner asked me to come up to his suite. And I think that Spock must have put some hash in the muffins, because before I knew it, Sulu and Chekhov were trying to board me like a Klingon warship.
No, not that Chekhov. No, no, this is the Russian author and playwright, Chekhov.
Oh, yes, of course. I met him at Mary Lou Henner's. Yes, he was wearing that hat. Yes, I'm... So sorry.
I'm sorry.
Yes, darling.
Could we start maybe with A Calamity?
We most certainly can.
Okay.
Yes. You're going to go into your world, and I shall stay in mine. Okay. Oh, my hair flatteners are going on.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, we're rolling.
A Calamity by Anton Chekhov. Sophia... Stop tape. Can I just check this name here? Is it Petrovna?
Petrovna.
Ah, Petrovna. We don't want to run around giving the blind faulty information now, do we?
we're still rolling.
Oh, you're still rolling?
Yes, take two.
Sophia Petrovna, the wife of... stop tape. I should have looked ahead. What is this next name? It's
Lubyantsev.
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 Lubyantsev. You know, I'm just thinking of the blind, and I think it's so important that they don't hear uncertainty in my voice, because, I mean, their dark, dreary worlds are uncertain enough, aren't they? Oh, God.
Are you all right? Do you need a moment?
I'm fine. It's okay. Yes. Sophia Petrovna, the wife of Lubyantsev, was walking slowly through the woods when they saw their friend Nikolai Chalakola.
Stop it.
What a
big name and so few vowels. Bobby, for the sake of brevity, darling, could we just call him Nicky Childs? Or, oh, Bobby, there you are.
Miss Granger, I think I have a better idea.
Chapter 10. Drugs, booze, Trekkies, and gangbangs. Oh, Bobby, this must be my chapter. Oh, did we stop tape then? I'm so sorry. I got excited. I wondered if I might be in the index. I am! I've always liked writers. I lived with a poet when I first came here, and he was beautiful in an undernourished sort of way. And he always looked as if he wasn't wearing enough clothes to keep him warm, and I used to love listening to his words and feeding him miso soup. I was very much in love. But after 8 months, he hadn't been published, so I broke it off. You see, in New York, there's a very fine line between genius and loser.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't see you there.
No, it was my fault. I was too absorbed in trying to find my number in the Dewey Decimal System.
Oh.
I see you were hunting down the same tome.
Guilty as charged. Oh. Yes, I'd be lost without the updated physician's desk reference, but of course, you first, you know.
Well, you know what we could do? We could take this book over to one of those tables over there and we could share it. Oh, I'm sorry, I've embarrassed you with my brashness, haven't I?
No, sure, it's a wonderful idea, but I don't know your name.
Well, I'm Gilbert Bronson, but my friends call me Gil.
Oh, I'm Kay. Oh. Kay Clark, which, that's what my friends call me too, I'm afraid so.
Well, sir, okay.
Begin the game, shall we? Oh. Heavens, sir. There are still gentlemen in this world.
Well, you know, sometimes it takes a real lady to bring that out in a man.
Oh. Gilbert Bronson, if you think you can sweet-talk me into letting you use a physician's desk reference first, it's working like a charm, so... Oh!
I got it.
I'm so sorry.
Well, I wasn't Kay Clark, but I am in a bit of a hurry here. I just have to look up amoxicillin, if you don't mind.
Ear infection. Touché. Yes, I think you'll find that aroxamycin is the preferred antibiotic for that particular bacterial strain.
Wow, you're absolutely right.
Ding, ding.
Are you a doctor?
Oh, no, no. I work at Van Nuys Savings and Loan.
Really?
Mm.
I'm at the Tarzana First Union Savings. In
Tarzana?
Yes.
Oh,
yeah. But how did you know about that stuff, though?
Well, I care for my bedridden mother.
Oh, sweet gods of coincidence.
What?
I take care of my bedridden father.
Oh. Mother's had over 100 different diseases diagnosed. She's almost left us a few times.
Father, too.
Oh.
Yes. Oh. Kay Clark.
Yes.
I had almost given up hope of ever finding anyone who might understand me. You know, somebody who wouldn't mind the occasional filthy hose accidentally left in the tub.
Oh, Gillett, it's like you're reading aloud from my diary. It's...
Ah, I must dash.
Me too.
Daddy's electric bladder is on a timer, and, well, his uric acid tends to
back up and cause sores.
Oh, jeez.
It's very nice to meet you, Gilbert Bronson. Yeah. Oh, it's uncanny, isn't it?
Yes.
Well, I see you use regular flavor Metamucil, too.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Not the strawberry flavor.
Oh, no, that would just irritate the bell.
Yes.
Surely,
yes.
As well.
Irritate.
Irritate.
Sure. Bye. Okay. Kay Clark.
Yes?
This can't be goodbye.
No.
Meet me here next Saturday at 1 o'clock. I'll get a Haitian day nurse. We could see each other for 3.5 hours.
Oh, I don't know. Who'd look after Mother? Well,
there
was Hector. He worked at the car wash, but he was a surgeon in Guatemala, so...
So it's a date?
Yes.
It's a date?
Yes.
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 Okay.
Oh, Gil.
Okay.
Gil.
Okay.
Oh, Gil.
Okay.
Oh.
Shh.
Of course.
Well, so.
Mustache.
Yes. Saturday.
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 Ta-da for now. I'm going out to see Gil now, Mother. Hector will be here if you need the car washed or some minor surgery. Now, Mother.
Don't tell me not to love your sit and putter. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade. Don't tell me not to fly, I simply got to. If someone takes a spill, it's me and not you. Who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade? I'm gonna live and live now. Get what I want, I know how. One goal for the whole shebang. One throw, that bell will go clang. Eye on the target and wham. One shot, one gunshot and bam! Hey, Gilbert Brown.
Something wonderful's happened.
What?
My daddy finally died.
Oh, Gil, I'm so sorry.
No, be happy for me. I'm free.
Oh,
and look what I have.
What?
Two tickets to Hawaii. Two.
Oh.
Come with me. Run away with me. Yes.
Yeah.
We'll get a nurse to take care of your mom. Come on.
You know, I can't, Gil. Mother needs me.
I thought that might be your answer.
Yes.
Yeah.
Aloha.
Mahalo, me lady.
Marvelous. Godspeed.
All right.
On your wiki bus. Yes.
Glasses.
All the medical reference sections and all the libraries and all the world. He had to walk into mine.
And rain on my parade.
I'm sorry.
I have had many offers to write my memoirs. Somebody say to call it Call Me Madam. I say no, it's too on the button, you know. But it's all in here, in my not-so-little black book. Sizes, names, peccadillos. Oh, yes. Can you imagine what a shit panic that would cause in this town if I published? Because many of these Hollywood people have married some of my girls. Some went on to become movie stars themselves. Others, they are married to crowned heads of Europe. Oh, all my girls are the creme de la creme.
They're all sluts!
Lad, you shut big. You know, maybe I don't do book. Because Gore Vidal, he tell me that book tour is very exhausting. Mm. So maybe they pay me not to publish.
Fern, guess who died?
Bella. Why do you always turn death into a quiz show? Hannah Mintz.
Guess again, Ruth Bernstein.
Oh, no! Oh, this is terrible! She still has my book!
What?
My personally to me signed Jekyll and Suzanne.
Fern, it's only a book. Think what Saul is going through.
He doesn't even know where the kitchen is. It's so much easier when the men die first.
I slept over to Doubleday. I waited 2 hours for her signature. I paid the price printed on the flap.
Did you speak with her?
Yes, I did. I told her the only other person I'd waited in line to meet was Golda Meir. And frankly, Jackie, I said, up close, you're more attractive.
Up close, Lyndon Johnson is more attractive. I never understood the fuss over Miss Suzanne. She wrote beach books. You could stand in the water and read at the same time.
Look, toast me a poppy seed. I gotta get over there and get it back before they have a tax sale. Young man, as you were removing the corpse, did you happen to see the book Valley of the Dolls beside her bed? Getting bleached on the balcony? Uh-huh. Face down beside the toilet?
No!
Hello? Knock, knock.
Oh. Are you from the catering?
No, Mr. Bernstein. It's me, Fern Rosenthal. My darling, when I heard about Ruth, I was so bereft. I ran all the way over here in my slippers on the cement. My darling, let me help you fold her personal items, spray a little Lysol. Box of books, huh?
Oh, Mum, this is a bad time for Mr. Saul. Please, you have to go now.
No, I'm not pleased to go now. I'm here to help one Jew to another.
Thank you, but we don't need you. Come on, Mr. Saul. I have a nice banana and shawl for you. Come on, Mr. Saul.
Darling, I just went. Why me? Why me? Go back into your condos. There's nothing more to see. You're so damn morbid.
Yiskadal, v'yiskadash, shemei rabah.
Sir, you can't go in now. We got to move. You can't go in.
V'yoskasei, l'olam, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Amen.
Amen.
And now let us pray silently.
Fern, are you all right?
Pantyhose by the pool is not my idea of a good time. I'm not breathing from the waist down. I'll be right back, girl. Okay.
Please.
Vincent, darling, I hate to send you out in the heat of the day, but there's a terrible smell in the driveway.
Don't worry, Mrs. Rosenthal. It's nothing.
Yeah, it's nothing till you find out they've been flushing adult diapers again and the whole complex backs up.
Oy vey.
Yes.
And so we bid farewell to Ruth. A wonderful wife, mother, and grandmother. Neighbor, condo board member, and swimmer.
Oh my God, all these books. I pray to God they alphabetized. Sexual positions for the elderly. Cunning lingus in a wheelchair. Step one, make sure the brake is on.
They thought of everything.
And now, please join the Bernstein family in the buffet line and sit shiver with them in the cabana.
Breakfast at Tiffany's. Due back at the Great Neck Public Library, January 5th, 1959. My God, these people are thieves.
Mrs. Oh, Mrs. Saul. Oh, today is the best day of my life.
Today.
Yeah, you said as soon as Miss Ruth did, we're going to be married, and you're going to bring my boys here from the islands.
Yeah, I'll do it now. You do something for me? Shut up about it. We got to play it cool. How's it going to look when four boys under 15 with dreadlocks show up?
You'd send for them today if you loved me.
I love you. I killed my wife for you, didn't I?
No! No more rumpy pumpy for you until I see my babies.
Hello, darling. I was just getting my book back that Ruth spent the last 3 months of her life with. Let me get out of your hair.
Fern, you heard too much.
I heard nothing, I swore nothing. Darling, I'm from New York. I don't get involved.
Fern, you got the biggest mouth in Boca.
What? No! Oh, my God! Oh! 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 Oh!
Have you finished?
And then I wriggled out from under him, and as I did that, I set off his medic alert pendant. And thank God they were there within 3 minutes with the pedal.
Oh, what a terrible experience.
Oh, it was terrible.
God. And you know, he and Winifred confessed this morning
they
to
did.
The police. Yeah. And you know how they killed him?
How?
Well, every morning they fed her half a bagel with a cream cheese and arsenic schmear.
So poisoning was the modus operandi.
Yeah. And you know, I was suspicious at that cremation. Because I don't have a single Jewish friend in an urn. Mm.
Yeah, only good for the beach.
Huh? Oh, that's...
This book saved my life, Phyllis.
No, it's not literature.
Ooh, Valley of the Dolls.
Yeah.
I haven't read that in decades. Can I borrow it, Fern?
No offense, darling, but it's available in paperback.
I read the book once, huh? It was green.
Well... Spring has sprung once more in our graceful gated community, and everybody knows what that means. It's time once again for the annual Godsend Family Book Burning Barbecue. We invite all of our good Christian neighbors to come over and bring all of the offensive material they've been able to confiscate from their local schools and libraries during the past year. And then we throw them on the fire, and we roast a whole suckling pig over the flames. Oh, it's such a good lesson for the children to see how a delicious meal can rise out of the blazes of evil. Oh, my goodness, how'd my pet Boone getting there? You know, it's always hard when you start a new movie, trying to prove yourself to the other stunt people, you know. Showing that you've got what it takes to hang from a fiery pole or dive headfirst through a patio deck, you know? That's why I always bring the book. That's right. The big one. Watch.
Oh, bloody hell! This isn't the right phone book. This is the Valley edition. I wanted West LA. Don't you hate it when that happens, fellas? Riding Gibson, hi.
Works every time. It's a lot easier than picking a fight with the biggest one.
Let's make movies!
Trace.
Good night, Trace.